I've been wearing this one all morning and I've already tested it twice and you're gonna be surprised. And I'm just gonna say it. It's working right now. It's working really good. But that doesn't mean it's gonna work good all the time, consistently, or that it's even doing what it's supposed to be doing. Welcome back as we continue our journey to explore the most accurate non-invasive glucose devices on the market. And today, we're diving into the high-tech world of smartwatches with one that claims to be a game changer. This is the Ditto, and it is $150 on Amazon right now. And that's a pretty hefty price tag. Its younger brother, the F57L that we had tested before, that one was only 30 bucks, but that one didn't work too good. And so does price really matter when it comes to these gadgets? We've been waiting for a while for Apple to come out with its non-invasive glucose smartwatch, and that's exactly what we're doing, we're waiting. But until then, we're gonna continue to test these devices. And this is the next one on the list. So can it be trusted? It's fancy, it's expensive, it's worked so far. Now let's get ready to separate hype from fiction with a quick rewind of what I went through this morning. So let's put this thing to the test right now. Right now it is 9:27 in the morning. I've already had coffee, I've had a snack, and I'm ready to do a workout. And usually what I do is I'll check my sugar, but since I'm not gonna be using the old Samsung Galaxy Watch, I'll go ahead and slap this puppy on. And before I take my first reading and leave the house, I'm gonna quickly go over the instructions. They're pretty vague. They do not tell me where I should be wearing this on my wrist, whether it should be high or low. They do not tell me to clean my wrist with alcohol. In fact, they just basically ask me to put it on and push the buttons in order to get a glucose reading. So the first test we're gonna do is with the AccuCheck guide. I am fully aware that blood glucose meters and non-invasive glucose meters and CGMs are not 100% accurate. I know that there are many factors that will determine whether or not you're getting accurate numbers as to where you poke yourself on the finger, which finger you poke, your hydration levels, the temperature outside. But I'm a normal person and I hope you're a normal person. We don't live in a science lab and we are not scientists. So we're normal people checking our numbers and I hope our devices are accurate enough for normal people. The people that actually wear these things. So first you want to make sure that you prepare your glucometer by preloading a test strip. Once it's reading appropriately, it'll tell you to apply blood. After that, use a brand new alcohol swab. Find a victim, go ahead and clean that baby up. Find a good location and make sure that it's dry. Good location usually is on the side of the finger there. All right, go ahead and prepare to give yourself a poke. Make sure you're aligned. Make sure that you got to get enough blood. And wait for your reading. All right, we are reading 135. So let's go ahead and compare that to our watch. Let's see what the old $150 Ditto watch has to say about this. All right, to get there from your watch, go ahead and turn on the screen and side scroll until you hit blood glucose. So we got sleep, we got heart rate, and this one is blood glucose. All right, it's telling me I have a 7.6 millimole per deciliter. So again, my AccuCheck said I had 135 milligrams per deciliter. And my watch said I had a 7.6 millimole per deciliter. The easy math on that, grab your phone, 7.6 on the calculator, multiplied by 18. That gives me a, holy cow, it's accurate, a 136. 135, 136. So far, it seems to be working. Oh, real quick, I need to show you something important. For us Americans that like to do milligrams per deciliter, there is a way to change that on this watch when you go into the settings on the phone. So I'm gonna show you so we can change that to milligrams per deciliter. So open up the H-band app. And from your dashboard, you go into mine, scroll down to unit settings, and then blood glucose units, and just switch that to milligrams per deciliter and confirm. Save. So go back over here. And there it is. It's reading 132 right now. Let's continue on the rest of our day. I'm gonna go swimming and I'll be back. So I was about to get in and I just realized something. With all the modes this thing has, it doesn't have a swimming mode. I don't even think this thing is waterproof. So I started looking it up on the website. I couldn't find anything. So I'm not gonna get it wet just so that I could finish this glucose accuracy test. But something that you should know, if you're gonna go exercising, make sure you put your insulin pump in activity mode if you have one, and get yourself a snack just in case you go low. All right, I'll talk to you when I'm done with this. All right, just finished up swimming and I'm about to eat lunch, but before I eat lunch, I wanna make sure that I check my blood glucose, compare that to the watch. With this lunch, I'm not gonna do any pre-bolus. I'm gonna go ahead and let it go high, and we will post-lunch get another reading for hyperglycemia and just do a comparative there to see if it's actually working. When I conduct these tests, I like to make sure that I get out of range, both high and low, to see if it's really doing what it says it's doing. So I'm gonna check my glucose, be back in a sec. Glucose here is reading 124. 124 on the BG, and we'll go ahead and check it on the watch. You see that? 126. So that's 126. This is surprising to me, because I thought it was gonna be really off like the other one, but twice it has only been off in less than 5 milligrams per deciliter. So both the morning and the after workout. Right here, 124, and right here, 126. So let's do the hyperglycemia test. I'm gonna go eat and I will see you afterwards. Okay, lunch is over. It was 11 o'clock when I had lunch. It's 12:30 now, and Dexcom says I'm at 191. As we know, Dexcom is 5 to 15 minutes behind. So we're gonna go ahead and check our BG. Good amount of blood. And the test. All right, 205. It's trying to tell me my glucose is 84. Let's read it again. Keep it flat. No movement here. 91. It went from 84 to 91. There you saw it, my BG was at 205. I just had lunch an hour and a half ago, so it has reason to be high. This is coinciding pretty close to the Dexcom. Obviously, we know the Dexcom has some latency, but the watch is reading 84. That's a completely different number. So again, I'm starting to believe that this may not be telling the truth. We'll continue to test this. Like we did last time. What I'm going to do right now is get into that gym, take some insulin, and get this thing going in a downward direction, close enough to be low or even low, and then we'll test it again and see if it's accurate. I'm technically not hypo yet, but I'm close. The Dexcom says I'm 79, and well, within 20 minutes I'll be 55. So, very soon, not yet. Very soon, I'm gonna check my blood sugar and I'll let you know. All right, we're at 68 milligrams per deciliter on the Dexcom with a downward trend. Expecting to be below 55 milligrams per deciliter within the next 20 minutes. And I feel like crap. Holy monkey butt. I'm ready to check my glucose. So first, what we're gonna do is check the glucometer and see what our actual BG is. So our BG was reading 62, and our $150 non-invasive blood glucose watch was reading 129. Again, it's off, and it seems to be the trend that we're seeing here is anything that's within the middle, a normal range, it's gonna impress you with a number that's pretty close to what you should be at. But anytime you are super high or pretty low, it's gonna be off. So we're gonna do one more test. So far, we're 50%. Two good ones, two bad ones. Time to check my glucose before dinner. So go ahead and start with the old finger prick. Ah, choose a victim, pinky. 139. All right, we'll check the watch. 92. So it's clear to see as the day has gone on, it just is consistently further away from itself. In the morning, it was really close. It was like 1 to 2 milligrams per deciliter off. Now we're looking at plus 10, plus 20. In one case, it was like almost 100. So seems like yet again, we are still on the search for a good non-invasive glucose monitor smartwatch. Apple, please save us from these crimes of humanity and people giving us these bad watches. I mean, I was gonna test this thing one more time, but the verdict is pretty much the same. You know, and I know this watch is a gimmick. It is something that people think it's okay to sell medical devices that are not accurate. And although there is a disclaimer that says, do not use this for medical purposes or to make medical decisions, why sell it? Why sell it and give me numbers if they're gonna be false numbers? It just doesn't make sense to me and to my subscribers and my community. But if you're a company out there and you have a good one, please email me, let me know, send me your device. I will test it for you and I'll help you show the world that this technology is something that we could look forward to. But as of right now, it is a fairy tale.